The Senate Minority Leader, Godswill Akpabio, has said that the bipartisan leadership in the Senate will enhance the delivery of democracy dividend. While speaking with journalists in Abuja, Akpabio said Nigerians have high expectations for good governance.
The reason is very simple. The economic situation in Nigeria today is not too good. The economy is not good and everybody is affected, irrespective of your political party. So it is the business of every Nigerian, either through prayers or through action, to support the president to put the economy together. And we can do so by collaborating with one another. That is why you see the kind of relationship that exists in the Senate between the senators, irrespective of political divide, because everybody is concerned about moving forward, about growing the economy, about taking care of insecurity, about ensuring employment opportunities for Nigerians. Everybody has a family. Hunger does not restrict itself to any political party.
Senator Akpabio also called on the leadership of All Progressive Congress to resolve the crisis rocking the party in the interest of the masses.
I said that the success of President Buhari will remain the success of my children and the success of all Nigerians. In spite of the fact that we are in the opposition right now, we are interested in helping the government to succeed. But please, the government must also help us to help them. And that means that the APC must quickly resolve all issues so that we in the PDP, who are very experienced in governance, can help them to succeed. That's the truth.
Muyo Bamdele reporting.
National President of the Nigerian Union of Journalists Abdul Wahid Odushile has urged all Nigerians to use the opportunity provided by the Freedom of Information Act to apply for certain information that will help promote our nascent democracy. The NUJ boss who stated this in Abuja when he was receiving the handing over note from his predecessor Malam Muhammad Garuba said that over time so many people have restricted the Freedom of Information Act to what only journalists can utilize.
You see, the problem with us in this country, like people say, is that we are in the era of sharp. We want everything now. We don't want to go through the process. It will take a while. You see, Nigerians, by the time they get used to the FOI bill, it's not about journalists all alone. I've been saying this thing. The individuals can also apply for information. There are certain things that are happening elsewhere that journalists don't know about. But if individuals also apply using the FOI bill to get the information out, then they can now give it to journalists that this was what we got from certain places, and I think the public should know. Then they can release it to us. We use EFY is not about journalists alone, it's about Nigerians. It's access to information. It didn't say access of journalists alone to information.
Speaking earlier, Odushile also added that this new administration will deliver on its campaign promises, which is to ensure prompt payment of journalists and also an establishment of a radio station by the union.
We have already made contacts with the Nigerian Broadcasting Commission, and in the next few weeks, not too long from now, we'll go and take a form formally to apply for the license to own a radio station. And we want to start with Abuja. And it will be a commercial station. It has to fend for itself to be a commercial station.
On his part, the immediate past president of the NUJ, Malam Muhammad Garuba, urged the new administration under Odushile to run an all-inclusive union and also be patient with everyone.
I will urge him to maintain the tempo. I will also urge him to ensure that he remains level-headed president. He should be able to accommodate our colleagues because journalists are very, very critical. He should have a listening ears. So I think these are very serious issues that if he's able to maintain it, I want to believe that he's going to succeed as president of NUJ.
Thank you.
High Point was the official handing over of the files and other assets belonging to the union to the incoming administration by Malam Garuba. From Abuja, I am Festus Ejiroga Nefifen for Ben Television. We'll be right back.
The Nigerian Labour Congress, NLC, has advised health workers in the country to support all levels of government to ensure that the polio-free state of the country is maintained till 2017. The president of NLC, Ayuba Mwaba, in a statement congratulated the workers and other professionals who worked assiduously with government to ensure that the country attained 1 year without any new case of polio. He commended the government and the leadership of the National Primary Healthcare Development Agency for campaigning against the disease that afflicts children.
Hi, Mike.
Babe, it's been over
12 hours. Are you done thinking about it?
Is the answer yes?
Convince me.
I know how much confidence style means to you. Let me take you somewhere.
What's that?
A superior leading international hospitality chain in the heart of Africa.
And?
They offer very distinct services. Their meeting halls and all their hotels offer conference solutions that can help plan a perfect function for any occasion. They feature outdoor catering and provide services for any size event.
Keep going. You got me thinking now.
The beauty, the decor, and the views. It's the hotel experience you always dreamed of. They have up-to-date entertainment and a variety served at the fast food restaurant and snack bar. Oh, and don't even get me started on the garden bar or the nightclub. You would have everything you need within your reach without having to go out.
Wow. So what if I want to...
Cook? They got you, babe. The rooms are thoughtfully furnished with facilities that aid proper cooking, just like you would at home.
Where is this place?
And it's sweet.
Wow.
So, will you marry me?
Yes. How can I refuse?
Not at Sweets, a colorful affair.
The National Secretary of Nigerian Labour Party, Barrister Kayode Ajulo, has criticized President Muhammadu Buhari-led administration over delay in the formation of federal cabinet. President Muhammadu Buhari had earlier announced that minister will be appointed in September this year. In a chat with Ben TV in Abuja, Kayode Ajulo said the Buhari administration is operating below expectation.
I believe Buhari signed social contract with Nigeria. That social contract is vote for me, this is what I'm going to do. And having cast our vote for you, it's expected that what you promise us is what you're going to do. You told us that from the beginning you are going to hit the ground running. Now the question is, are you doing that? Now to tell Nigerians that I'm going to wait till September. The question is that what will now happen from the day you are sworn in? The constitution is so clear when the government of the day should start. And that has started. And the same constitution made it mandatory that there must be cabinet by the ministers. And not only that, it must even make me ensure that each of the states must have a minister, at least. Now the question is this. Are you not violating the law? Are you not disregarding the law? And remind you, from the time you are voted into office, before you're swearing in, it's within the lapse of almost 2 months. What are you doing within all those time? Mind you, this is the government that promised us change. The former president, one of the major accusations against him is that he's too slow, he seems to be incompetent, he seems to be, but unfortunately, what Nigerians are seeing is exactly what they did not want.
The Labour Party National Secretary also condemned 50% salary cut of President Buhari and his vice, Yemi Osinbajo. Ajulo explained that the salary cut was unconstitutional.
That is another violation of our law. The strength of our law, when it comes to issue of salary of political office holders, we have referendum, mobilization and physical commission that takes care of all those ones. They are the one, part of their function is to fix the salary of the president, fix the salary of the vice, of the political office holders, to fix them the remuneration, and apart from that, to talk about how to disburse revenues of government. Now, when you are disposing, when you are now saying you are slashing your salary, the first question that you come to every right-thinking Nigerian to say that, okay, the money you now slash now, what are you going to use for? Of course, it lacks power to disburse the revenue of Nigeria without the requisite law. Now, to now single-handedly decide that I want to slash it is now causing a gulp in our financial account in Nigeria. Because the first question is that where will the money go to? Under which head are we going to put the money? If you now tell me that, look, I'm going to collect only 10% or 2%, I'm going to collect anything, but I'm going to send it to charity, I think we should understand. But to say I'm going to slash it, at the end of the day, you want to be the account of Nigeria to be in total mess. This is a very simple financial accounting. This is a very simple issue of actuary arithmetic. And apart from that, you lack the power to increase your salary. I even lack the power to reduce your salary. Nigeria is a country governed by laws.
Muyo Bamdele reporting.
The management of the Nigerian Petroleum Corporation, NNPC, has announced that the Port Harcourt and Warri refineries have been successfully restreamed after a 9-month phase rehabilitation exercise conducted by its in-house engineers and technicians. The corporation, in a statement signed by the Group Managing Director, Group Public Affairs, Ohi Alegbe, revealed that both plants have commenced preliminary productions, adding that while the Port Harcourt refinery is ramping up its operation to about 60% of its 210,000 barrel per day nameplate capacity, the Warri refinery production is projected to hit 80% of its installed 125,000 barrel per day capacity. The NNPC informed that the Port Harcourt refinery is projected to boost the nation's local refining capacity with a product yield of 5 million liters of petrol per day, while Warri refinery would contribute 3.5 million liters of petrol to local refining capacity. Providing insight into the rehabilitation exercise, the NNPC noted that it adopted the phased rehabilitation strategy after the original refinery builders, ORB, who were initially contacted for the project, came up with unfavorable terms. In a related development, the NNPC has disclosed that it has successfully recovered the System 2B pipeline, which was recently breached at Areepo, Ogun State.